Hi, Dan Alasso with History for Today. And this morning I want to begin my third chapter of Modern World History, which looks at the Americas and at Columbus. Now, when your parents were in school, certainly when I was in school, modern world history and American history even usually began in 1492 with Christopher Columbus or Cristoforo Colón's discovery of America. And even today, typical histories of America tend to consider the moment of Columbus's landing in the Caribbean on October 12th, 1492, to be a significant moment and to be a big turning point, which I agree that it was. Some people continue to consider Columbus a heroic explorer, while others nowadays regard him as a monster, and some even accuse him of deliberate genocide. I agree that European contact with the Americas was a momentous event, but I would argue that the story is a little bit more complicated than it's usually depicted. Today, I'm going to try to add a bit of detail to those stories that many of us grew up with. In 1500, European and Asian populations had pretty much recovered from the plagues of the previous two centuries and were on the rise, as we've talked about earlier. The Ming Empire had a population of about 125 million people, which accounted for nearly 30% of the world's total population of around 440 to 450 million. The Ming Dynasty, which we've talked about previously, is remembered as one of the greatest eras of orderly government and social stability in human history. It began, as you recall, in 1368 and continued until 1644. The Mughal Empire hadn't quite begun yet in India. It started in 1526. Although the subcontinent held nearly 100 million people, the Aztec Triple Alliance in central Mexico ruled over up to 25 million people. Japan's shoguns ruled about 17 million people. The French crown and the Holy Roman Empire each controlled a population of about 16 million. And the Inca Empire in South America ruled 12 million subjects, and the Ottoman Empire in the Eastern Mediterranean controlled about 11 million. So continentally, Asia dominated. China led the world with its 125 million, followed by India with 90 or 100 million, and then the regions of Europe and Africa had about 80 million each. And the Americas themselves probably contained about 65 million people. And I'm stressing this because I think it's very important to understand that on the eve of Europe's discovery of the Americas, the populations of Europe and Africa and the Americas were very similar. This demographic parity changed very quickly, as we will soon see, and that's a big part of our story. So before I continue, let's pause briefly for a couple of questions for discussion. Firstly, why do you think stories of Columbus remain so controversial today? And secondly, why is it important that Europe and Africa and the Americas had populations of similar size just before 1492?